These are the top 10 times NBA players, plus millions of fans. And for number 10, one mistake made Rudy Gobert the most hated man in America. See, back in 2020, at the start of the pandemic, Rudy thought it'd be a good idea to make fun of COVID by literally wiping his hands all over the mics at a press conference. And what do you know? The very next day, it was revealed that Rudy tested positive for the virus, forcing the NBA to suspend the rest of their season. And when fans found out, they annihilated Rudy on Twitter, blaming the entire league shutdown on his little microphone stunt. Rudy, you deserve Shaq and a full MVP for that. Damn. But hey, it doesn't always take getting an entire NBA season suspended to lose fans. Cause at number 9, all Kevin Durant did was send a couple of DMs. Yeah, back in 2020, KD saw something interesting pop up on his Twitter feed. Comedian Michael Rapaport calling him out for being sensitive. And obviously, KD was a little upset about it. So, he decided to clap back at the guy by calling him a pale, pasty, guzzling head, saying he'd spit in his face, threatening to fight him. KD even brought up the man's wife. God damn. And after this, Michael was so offended, he decided to expose KD by leaking the DMs, causing a media firestorm. It was trending on Twitter, covered by the mainstream media, debated on ESPN. Everyone was talking about it, and people were so outraged, the NBA fined KD $50,000, leaving him with no choice but to apologize.
What's your response to the reaction to the, you know, the social media messages that were made public?
I'm sorry that people seen the language I use. It's not really what I want people to see and hear from me, but hopefully I can move past it and get back out on the floor.
All right, I mean, KD might've went a little too far with those DMs, but he still didn't lose as many fans as LeBron James did at number 8. Cause this dude pissed off the entire city of Hong Kong. Yeah.
April 3rd, 2019. The Chinese government introduces a new law that gives them more power over Hong Kong citizens. October 1st, protests erupt across Hong Kong in opposition to the new law. October 4th, NBA executive Daryl Morey decides to tweet a support for the protesters instead of the Chinese government. This turned out to be a huge problem. See, the Chinese government was responsible for over $500 million a year in NBA sponsorships. And after seeing an NBA executive side against them, they immediately pulled all of their brand deals. So of course, LeBron was asked to comment on the situation, being the face of the NBA and all. And instead of showing support for Daryl and the protesters, he said this.
I don't want to get into a word or sentence feud with Daryl, but I believe he wasn't educated on the situation at hand. Social media is not always the proper way to go about things as well. Even though, yes, we do have freedom of speech, but there can be a lot of negative that comes with that too. But that's just my belief.
Yeah, shooting down Daryl's tweet might have got Bron some brownie points with the Chinese government, but the citizens of Hong Kong were pissed. And this one statement ended up losing him millions of supporters.
And people stopped burning his jersey. Like, I run a social media page, people send me like video, they stopped burning LeBron jersey just because of his speech. Hong Kong people are really suffering right now, and now you come up with speech like that, we are anger, we are very angry at that.
Damn, Bron, you messed around and pissed off an entire city. But at least this incident didn't end LeBron's career, cause people are trying to get Charles Barkley fired for what he does in number 7. Yeah. See, ever since Charles became an analyst for Inside the NBA, there's been one thing that he just loves making fun of. The women of San Antonio.
I miss San Antonio, one of my favorite cities.
Why do you like San Antonio?
Oh, man. Oh, them big old women down there.
Oh, why? That's why them big old women be eating those churros.
Double fist.
Oh, they be double fist, no churros, man.
What they need, Chuck, they need big draws.
Eat them big old bloomers.
I bet you couldn't do that to them big ass women in San Antonio. Oh.
And they want me to apologize. That's not going to happen.
What
that's
they want not you apologize gonna happen. For?
Me joking about those big old women down in San Antonio.
All right, look, Charles is just having some fun, making some fat jokes. But it turns out, there was one massive group of people that were not amused.
Karens. Because in 2019, a reporter went viral criticizing Charles on Twitter, getting Karens across the country to join in, trying to cancel him. And with so many people being offended, the bosses at TNT decided to sit Charles down and tell him, stop joking about San Antonio women. And Charles, man, he's just upset about the whole thing.
They won't even let me talk about San Antonio anymore. You know, what I'm always talking about, them big old women down in San Antonio? They're like, Charles, we got one lady wrote an article. Yeah. I'm like, we've been having fun with this for probably 10, 15 years. and everybody's trying to get everybody fired, and it really sucks.
Hey, Charles, I mean, it could have been a lot worse. Because what Chris Paul did in number 6 cost him fans and a fat bag. See, back in 2012, Chris was playing a game against the Cavs when, in the third quarter, referee Laura Holtkamp hit him with a technical foul. And Chris was so upset that, after the game, he threw some shade at her in an interview.
That's terrible. Yeah. There's no way that can be a technical. We try to get the ball out fast every time down the court.
Yeah.
And when we did that, she said, and I said, why uh-uh? And she gave me a tech.
Okay.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
If that's the case, then this might not be for her.
This might not be for her. Those 6 words sent the media into a frenzy because people took this comment as Chris being offensive towards women. So news sites and fans all over the country started trashing Chris, calling him a sexist. And with tons of people calling for his head, the NBA decided to punish Chris by slapping him with a $25,000 fine. That's tough. But it's better than what Terrence Williams got in number 5. Because this dude did something that not only lost him fans, but also has him facing 20 years in prison. See, back in 2017, Terrence thought it'd be a good idea to scam the NBA's health insurance by billing them for medical procedures he never even got. And in the process, Terrence conned them out of hundreds of thousands of dollars. So, thinking he just discovered a genius way to make some money, Terrence decided to tell some of his old NBA buddies about the scheme. Guys like Glenn Davis, Tony Allen, Sebastian Telfair, everybody was getting a check. But after 3 years of scamming, people started getting sloppy, making grammatical errors, misspelling names. I mean, Greg Smith even claimed he saw a dentist in California when he was actually in Taiwan. Idiot. So eventually, the FBI caught wind of the scheme, and in October of 2021, it was announced that 18 former NBA players were arrested for defrauding the league out of $4 million, not only sparking outrage across the media and NBA fans, but also putting every last one of these players at risk for serving 20 years in federal prison. 20 years for $4 million split 18 ways. Man, I don't think that scheme was worth it. And what Kevin Garnett said in number 4 wasn't worth it either. Cause this dude said something so despicable, he's still hated by millions to this day. See, back in 2010, KG's Celtics were taking on the Pistons, when late in the fourth quarter, he came toe to toe with Charlie Villanueva, a player with a rare disease called alopecia that prevented hair growth. And despite knowing about Charlie's condition, KG hit him with the most disrespectful piece of trash talk imaginable, saying, "You look like a damn cancer patient." Yeah. And when Charlie tweeted about the comment after the game, the incident made national headlines, angering fans around the country, costing KG the respect of millions, and leaving a permanent stain on his reputation. But at least KG wasn't losing fans on purpose. Because in number 3, Ben Simmons is doing everything he can to make people hate him. I mean, not only did he pass up on a wide open dunk and cost his team the 2021 playoffs, but he also didn't drop a like and subscribe to the channel. Oh, what the hell is this guy thinking? I hate Ben Simmons. And the man didn't stop there, because he ended up demanding a trade from the 76ers. And when they couldn't make it happen, he decided to pull a little hissy fit, getting kicked out of practice in his first week back and getting suspended. And after this incident, man, Philly fans are just depressed, out here burning jerseys and everything. But hey, I mean, if Ben somehow ends up playing well again, he might be able to gain some fans back. Unlike Shaq. Cause what he did to his fans in number 2 will tarnish his reputation for the rest of his life. See, back in 2014, Shaq posted a picture of himself to Instagram, making fun of this guy, Jamel Binion. and Shaq might have thought the post was funny, but when Jamel saw it, he was crushed. It turns out that he has a rare condition called ectodermal dysplasia that caused his face to develop abnormally. So after Shaq's picture went viral, a news station ended up tracking Jamel down for an interview. And well, it'll break your heart.
I was kind of hurt. Y'all look up to him, you know, I watched Shaq play basketball his whole season, so I'm like, why he making fun of me when he's supposed to be this role model?
When people saw this interview, they started blasting Shaq, saying his post was offensive, that he should be ashamed of himself and apologize to the guy. And even though Shaq did get in touch with him to say sorry, the damage had already been done. Damn, Shaq. Messed up with this one, dog. Come on! But as messy as this incident was, it gets even worse with number one. Because Kyrie Irving cost himself fans millions of dollars and his NBA career, all because of the one shot he refused to take. See, in September of 2021, reports came out about Kyrie not being vaccinated. And this was a big deal, because if Kyrie didn't get the vaccine, he wouldn't be allowed to play home games in Brooklyn. So people figured eventually he'd just get the shot and return to playing ball. But in October of 2021, all hell broke loose, because the Nets ended up releasing a statement saying Kyrie would not be allowed to participate in any team activities until he got the vaccine. And in response, Kyrie went live on Instagram to say he still wasn't going to get vaccinated, causing absolute chaos across the country.
This is some of the stupidest nonsense I've ever seen.
I would go upstairs and say, get him up out of here. Get his ass up out of here.
Kyrie Irving is not a victim. Being unvaccinated does not make him a hero.
You can mess up your money, but you're not messing up our money.
That is correct.
As simple as that.
Retire. Retire then.
The NBA media, national news outlets, fans, everyone was ripping into Kyrie, to the point where even the NBA's commissioner went on TV and asked Kyrie to get the vaccine.
He needs to get vaccinated.
But he still hasn't listened. So as it stands today, Kyrie is set to forfeit up to $17 million of his NBA salary, the ability to play basketball, and the support of millions of NBA fans. Damn. But you know what could use some support? This video right here! This is the one-armed kid NBA players fear. What are you doing, man? Click it!